Well, congrats for such an amazing one. I felt like it touched on, you know, the history, the present, and also the future with, like, you guys are, like, so young and inspiring. How personal did all this feel to you?
Very personal, for sure. I can relate to a lot of Star's experiences. But also, you know, these events are real, you know, so this was a reflection of reality. And it didn't feel like it was challenging to reach for the emotion of mourning the lives of members in the Black community that we've lost to police brutality. And although I've never had anyone close to me experience that, I have had people that I know be victims to gun violence. You know, I think we all grieve when we see someone die. Like, we all grieve. We all grieved Tamir Rice, we all grieved Sandra Bland, you know, Michael Brown. And so it wasn't difficult to reach for that feeling.
Yeah, I feel like it seems personal to everyone, really, and so. Also, like, it touches on such heavy topics, but it's also great in terms of entertainment value. Do you think that's the perfect recipe for a movie? Or are those the type that you like to go and watch?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's like the medicine with the sugar, right? I definitely think that's a really great way of making people understand something and also not be afraid of it, you know, is when it is entertaining. As someone recently described the movie as like a modern day superhero film, which is like the coolest thing that I've heard. And also, you know, speak to its kind of genre as a young adult film, which is cool too. I think, you know, it's like sometimes detrimental to look at political events outside the context of, you know, just being human. Like, further politicizing politics can sometimes be detrimental to fully understanding them and empathizing with them. So I think that was kind of our intention with making it.
Do you think there are enough of those kinds of movies being made in 2018?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's definitely a push for diversity within media, which is so cool to watch. You know, portraying narratives that don't always get to be portrayed, and that in itself is politicized, you know? And that's cool to see. Like, I'm happy to see more queer narratives, more Black narratives. Even if they don't tackle specific political events, it's still exciting to see them placed at the forefront. And see people who we don't always get to see exist, you know?
Definitely.
Something for my godson Elijah and little girl named Corinne.
Man, you coming at me for my music, but you listen to this old stuff.
Old stuff? What? You better get up out of here with all that pockets of truth.
The reception has been amazing. How did it change your life as an actress since this came out?
I was walking down the street the other day and someone was like, "Hey, yo, it's Star!" And that was the first time that happened. So I'm definitely witnessing a shift. I don't know, I think I'll have to see. It's just been so amazing. Just like the emotional responses that people are having are so like visceral and like earnest, and you know, I think they're really feeling it. And I think for some people it's changing their perceptions. For some people it's making them feel more valid in their identities. And like, that's all we wanted to do.
Right back to the movies. Talking back to the screen, drinking liquor. Having big dreams of getting richer. I'm living that thug life. Y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do. Stay true.
I love the references of Tupac and, you know, old school music, but it's still super relevant. Were you a fan? Did you like that?
Yeah, I grew up listening to Pac with my sister, but I didn't really understand and have that like relationship to him that like Angie has until the book and until we worked on the movie, and like listening to him was something that I did to prep for it, and I felt like I understood so much more, like his theology and his entire approach to his artistry and what he was sharing in the world, you know, was so powerful and so nuanced. And like Angie often says that when she wrote the book, she wanted to make her books feel like what it feels like to listen to Tupac, you know, be able to experience a myriad of emotions, whether it's anger or fear or joy or love. She wanted you to be able to feel all of it within the hate you give. And so I just think, I don't know, that's so beautiful.
Definitely, it definitely worked. I mean, I was looking around me, everyone was feeling all the emotions.
Yeah.
It wasn't just me. Thank you. So
thank you. Achieve the inconceivable. We don't
belong, but we hear unbelievable. When you're ready to talk, you talk. Don't ever let nobody make you be quiet.
I ain't named you Star by accident.